Today we will be reviewing the Bachmann Easy App Touchscreen Train Control Blue Lightning. Let's go! Alrighty, let's start looking at this beautiful thing. Alright, so as you guys can see, it's the blue lighting. It's a Santa Fe car. It includes a train, three other cars, a gondola, a boxcar, and a caboose. And as you see, your Bluetooth, 4-supported Apple smart device, and Easy App downloaded required for operation. So you're able to control this train on your phone. And on the back side, again, it just shows what other little fancy bits and everything with the Bluetooth. It has a 56-inch, 36-inch oval with the nice snap-fit nickel silver. That's the gray ones. Those are the nice ones. And also with the Bachmann Easy Track system, which is phenomenal. And then, like I said before, yeah, you can control it with your phone or Apple tablet device. Let's open this up. Starting it out, you have all the important digits, getting on the track for more fun, and other manuals and whatnot as well. Yeah, we'll look at this one first. Alright. So down over here is all the track. This is your nickel silver that I was talking about earlier. So how you snap these together, it's super easy. I'm gonna try to get it in shot. So you have it right over here, right? Just called Easy. It's called Easy Track for a reason. Simple as that. I'll show you again. So we grab the other tracks, make sure that your rail joiners are nice and lined up, make sure it's nice and smooth. Do a little push, and to make sure they're even, you rub it across. And look at that. One piece of track, quarter of a track already done. What's really great about this set is not only do we get two straight tracks, but we actually get four. And a lot of sets don't come with four tracks, so thank you Bachmann for allowing us to have four tracks. So if you noticed on the side or even on the box art, there's nowhere do you see a transformer. And that's because everything is through this little box and through this switch. Right over here. So what you would normally do, you plug it in from here on the side. Oh, come on. There we go. A little bit of a tight fit. A little tight fit. And then you just plug it into a wall outlet. Like so. This is where the train gets all of its main power from. However, so obviously, so you put this on, the train gets its power, then you control the speed from your phone. However, let's say you grabbed one of your older trains, right, and you wanted to run it on the track. Well, unfortunately, it would stay at 100. It would always go really fast. You wouldn't be able to control it. That's the only downside to this. But get rid of the controller, but still just use an old transformer. As you can see, my stuff's a little on the older side, but it still works, and that's what's important. Let's move all these tracks over here. Alright, now let's look at the trains. Okay. So here are the trains. The beautiful Santa Fe. Nice. Now let's look at the gondola car first. Alright, very nice. Turn it on the side, upside down. Very nice. Oh yeah, you hear that nice little rain kind of sound of the metal wheels and the metal track. It's phenomenal. Let's get you on a freight car. Very nice. And the door's actually open, and inside, I don't know if you can look, there are little metal plates inside That way it'll give this car a lot more weight, which is fantastic. Now we have a nice little Santa Fe caboose. Perfect. Okay, now some people are gonna hate me. How do you attach your cabooses? Do you do it? Do them at the end like this? Or do you do dome first? People always yell at me no matter which one we do. I personally always do the dome at the end. But who really knows? What's the correct way to doing it? Alright, and now here comes the big beauty himself. The Blue Lightning Santa Fe train. Get that in shot. Alright, and when holding this guy surprisingly has a lot of weight on him. Meaning, so he's very strong. So you know, the heavier the train is, the more it can pull it, the more it can kind of do other hills and climbs and do whatever you really want it to do. But if this is a great train, and as you'll see, it has an operating headlight, so the lights will come on when I use my phone to plug it in. Alright. Looking at all this, we have all the track right over here, and of course the train. I'm then going to obviously use my own phone, and it's actually an Android phone, so you know that it still works with either Android or Apple. We're going to look at this, we're going to test it out, I'll get it fired up and ready to go. Alright, so I'm just doing a little test right now. I just have the piece of track going all the way down, all the way on my bed over there, and kind of stopping right there. I have the cord over here plugged all the way in with the on switch connected all the way down there. I'm just going to get the rest of these cars in, and then we'll fire up the train. So what's really nice about this set is that it uses the 18-inch radius curves, meaning if you try to make a full semicircle, it's going to be 36 inches, aka 3 feet. And so if you're working with a very small area of space, usually when you're having those 18-inch radiuses, that's the best way to do anything when it comes to having a layout. Sometimes if you're going to have, you know, longer locomotives, or if you're going to try to do like a, you know, a giant, you know, passenger set, it's always good to go the long ones. Let's kind of set that off right there. Get our guy in here. Is he on? No, he is not on the track. Oh, come on. There we go. Alright. So you're going to go on your either the App Store, Google Play Store, whatever you have, and you are going to get the Bachmann Easy app right over here. Alright. Alright. Perfect. Then you're going to hit, so already it says My Locomotives. We're going to hit Connect. Ooh, okay. So now it's green. Alright, so it is green. I'm sorry, you can't see it. We're then going to hit this button that says Standard. Everything's loading in. Alrighty. Now on the top, though, it says Bachmann Loco. So if I actually go over here and kind of change it up, I can actually change what type of train it is. So I go back to under settings. See, we have Loco, we have Bachmann, we have Loco name. So I'm actually going to go change that right now. We're going to call it just Santa Fe. Alrighty, perfect. And then there's actually a multiple different types of things. So there's Loco type, so it's a diesel, so that's number one, that's important. But if you looked, I'll actually go back, when you see steam train, right, there's a chuff sequence, or sinking, I mean, chuff sinking, meaning that the chuffs could be synced to the wheel, so every time that the wheels go down with the pistons, you'll hear a ch, ch, ch sound, it'll sync up, so it'll sound the same, it'll just sound the same, which is amazing. So I'm going to switch back again to diesel. And then you can actually control the top speed. So right now the top speed was at freight of 60. So I'm actually going to go, well, there's two different. There's switcher, which is 25%, 25 miles per hour, freight, which is 60, passenger is 80, and then full speed 100. So let's full speed. I'll still be able to control it anyway. So let's see. And then there's a control skin. So I just hit steel, meaning now when I switch, to go to my throttle. Look at that. It's all steam related now. So let's hit start up. And look at that. You already hear the diesel purring up. And that sound's coming from my phone, actually. Now, so I can do it, let's see if I can time this right. I'm going to hit the light. And just like that. And then there's two buttons for a short horn and a long horn. Let's hear the short one. Let's hear the long one now, because I can control how long it goes. Oh, I love that. Okay. And then you have a nice bell feature, too. Making sure it's going forwards. Wait, I can do this. Alright, ready? He's on the noisy side for the diesel. I don't know why. And then I could slow it back down, or I can hit shutdown. And just like that. Alright, let's do it again. So let's try this again. Alright, we'll go this way. And make sure we're on reverse. There we go. So what's interesting is originally the top speed was only 60 miles per hour when I first opened this thing, so I didn't think at first that it was able to go higher. But I didn't realize how fast this train can go, which is phenomenal. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, I love it. Okay. I'm going to lower that a little bit. So this set, this full track, even though I know that I have it kind of stretched out as far as I can go, this set can go from 3 feet, or it can make a layout, sorry. It can make a layout of 3 feet by 6 feet, which is huge. And really, I think it's just because of those extra straight track pieces. So really, you can kind of change the dimensions of the layout. You can get rid of two of the switch tracks and do a plain, you know, 4 feet by 3 feet, which is awesome. Or you could even change it. Use each of these straight tracks as like a square, which I might be able to try to show you. And you can kind of have, what would that be, 3 feet, almost like 4 feet by 4 feet, like a perfect square, which is really awesome to have for these kind of layouts. But yeah, so this little guy is awesome. Just the fact that you're able to control it from your phone, you don't have to worry about any wires, you don't have to worry about anything like that. Like, again, this is a really great set. And look at that, look how slow it does the climb and that crawl. That's phenomenal. I feel like my camera doesn't do it justice. It's really great just to see it in person. It really is. And I stopped it. Perfect. Okay. So this set is a little bit on the pricier side. I was very fortunate enough for Bachmann to actually send this to me so I can review it to talk about it. And it's great. It'll work on all different layouts and sets, which is phenomenal. Like I said before, though, if you want to have other trains that do not run on this app, you would just have to take off this wire and just put your own wires and transformer in. Easy, you know, not really easy to do that. But, yeah, it's a little on the pricier side with this set. It was on Amazon. To get like a standard price, I saw was $150 is the average. Sometimes it can go up to $300. So really it's about just trying to find your set. It's also important to know how much space that you have. So right here, if you kind of see, you know, I can try to make a little oval, you know, on my bed over here, but it's a little tricky. But I can always have, but I always have space underneath my bed. It's like a monster under there. Anyway, so yeah, so definitely there's plenty of space that I have here. So I can try to make a full circle. I might just put it on the floor and I'll kind of show you. Or another option you could do is grab a piece of styrofoam, if you have, or cardboard, and kind of make like a true flat surface layout. That way you can put it on top. So I'll be kind of doing updates and try to do something like that in the future. Obviously, though, if you have smaller tables, You can always do other scales as well, like N scale or Z scale. But for as far as this Atrix set goes, no, I love this thing. This is phenomenal. Bring in the back again. I love the horn. Anyway, guys, then that might do it for this episode. Anyway. Alright, guys, again, thank you again for so much for coming and joining me for today's episode for Bachmann Blue Lightning. A really good set. I like the different, obviously, I like that it's in Santa Fe, you know, the Union Pacific kind of area of the U.S. And the amount of tracks that you have is phenomenal. The fact that we're able to get four straight tracks. And not two. It shows something. It really does mean something. As though it's as simple as just, you know, adding one extra straight track. It means something. It really does. But yeah, I think that's going to do it for this episode. Definitely look into the set. And there's plenty of other trains under the Easy app, it's called, that you can run your trains on. Fortunately, I only have this one that you can run on your phone. But there are plenty of others that you have here. I know, I think there's a couple of locomotives, other diesels, I'm not quite sure. But yeah, definitely it's worth investing and looking into. But yeah, that's gonna do it from here, guys. Alright, thank you so much. Have a good day. See you.